If we want, we're gonna have a bunch of numbers that we wanna put in order from least to greatest. This first number, -12.1, repeating. My recommendation is just go in and turn every number, first of all, into a decimal. This one is already basically a decimal, so I'm just gonna arrow off to the side and expand that a little further. 12, -12.1 with a bar over the one is -12.111111 forever. Okay, then the next one, 12 1/10. If you wanna turn that into a decimal, what you're gonna do is grab your calculator and first just turn the fraction part into a decimal. So I'm gonna do 1/10. When you read a book from left to right, we have 1, and then next line divided by, next line, 10. So if you take 1 and divide it by 10, your calculator is going to say 0.1. Now there's still a 12 in front of this. So if I put the 12 with the 1/10, or in other words, the 12 with the 0.1, that's going to give me 12.1. Okay, then this fraction here, changing it to a decimal, reading it from left to right and working your way down, we have, it's a negative, but it's 86, next line, divided by, next line, 7. So if you type in 86 divided by 7, your calculator says 12.28571, and it keeps going. This is a negative number, so it's still a negative number. So I'm coming off to the side here and just saying I've got -12.285, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, then one more number here, square root of 145. We just showed how to put in a square root in your calculator. So you do the square root of 145. And once you've typed in the square root of 145, the screen is gonna be filled with numbers. So coming off to the side, I now have 12.041. To me, the easiest way to determine which numbers are the biggest and the smallest is I'm gonna focus on the money part of it. Okay, so if I only focus on the first two numbers, this says I owe somebody $12.11. Now this number here, we should have two numbers after the decimal to make it look like money. So I'm going to put a zero at the end. And then this one is now $12.10. Okay, this number, again, just focusing on the dollars and cents. This one would be like I owe somebody $12.28. And then this one here, I have $12.04. Remember, we want to eat the one you want. The smallest one is the worst situation. So in the situations here, owing somebody $12.28 would be the worst. And then after that, owing somebody $12.11, that's a little bit better. Okay, then the other two numbers are positive. Here I have $12.04. I have $12.04. And this one I have $12.10. So $12.04 is the next one. And then $12.10 is the very biggest one. Now what you'll be able to do is take the original numbers and just drag them and drop them. So you're gonna take the one that goes with -12.28, this one here, which is -86/7, and that goes first. Okay, then -12.11, the top one, you grab that one and drag it and drop it. So if you just drag and drop the originals in the order, you'll be done. Okay, so you're just arranging them from least to greatest, but turn them into decimals. Know that negative means you owe money, positives you have money.